this place is not secure. I'm not secure here. Yes. So I'm demanding that technical team, Bwana Kawesi, in your other capacities, you make sure that they start here. Access control, perimeter security. These are the things we preach to others, yet we don't apply them to ourselves. And that should apply to all police stations, police installations, because we are now a target of terrorists.
If the Inspector General of Police is worried of his own security, then the question is, what about the common Ugandan? Uganda police are credited for doing everything in their capacity to ensure and reduce the crime rate in the country. However, the boss admits that there is a missing link which needs to be bridged.
So when people are gathered, like somebody can just drive a truck and you don't, it's no longer sophisticated. Then of course, other forms, shootings and things like that, like these killings of assassinations of like Major Chigun, these on border bone, armed attacks along on the way. Then of course there is also, apart from terrorism, there is actually violent attacks, even in the public vehicles, public transport vehicles. People come in and they just freeze people.
Kayihura adds that the country is also mad with mafia-like people who have infiltrated all the systems of the country, from economic sector to even the security institutions, and this has continuously affected the safety and livelihoods of many Ugandans.
We are faced with mafia-like criminal gangs and networks. Kampala is awash with conmen who have infiltrated the system. A number of cases you have reported them in the media. Where conmen, for example, if they have got scouts, for example, in the banking system, who alert them as to who has got money on which account, and collaborate with them to access those accounts with the support of banking staff in the banks. And then, of course, plus another, and these conmen involve, even they involve our security personnel. We have arrested some. Yeah. They infiltrate the police, they infiltrate the military, they have infiltrated everywhere. So that's why I'm calling it mafia-like, because that's how mafia works.
On the criminal groups that have made it a norm to rob people, especially the city dwellers, the police has assured Ugandans that these will soon be wiped out, since some of their commanders have already been arrested.
We embarked on our operations, which were mostly intelligence-led, and we were able to net 12 suspects. And these were young children, between 12 years and 16 years, who were staying in Gayaza, but being deployed in Tinda in different points. And their commander was a border rider who has a stage in Tinda.
Who would be their scout?
Their scout. Mm. And who would pick them on his motorcycle, deploy them in the different spots. So we were able to identify them, and we even took them to the victims. They also described how they used attack. So they were the real actual...
They confessed?
They confessed, and we have them, took them to court.
Today, we are activating our interagency technical inspection team led by CT to go around checking these places to ensure that the procedures, and in Ukawesi we must include police headquarters.
During this festive season, however, the crime rate reduced drastically. For example, cases of homicide reduced from over 50% from last year's festive season to 33%, attributed to public vigilance and the crime preventers that have greatly helped the police. This report by Rachel Nachiwala for PM Live.